Allowed.
Hello, dancers across the globe. My name is Jeremy, and today I have a fabulous Cammy with me, who's going to assist us in doing some Shag, and then later on some Balboa. But this is a Shag class, so this is beginning intermediate with a little bit of spice in the middle. Okay.
Yeah.
On the other side, we have Lauren and Laura.
Yeah.
Hello.
I'm Laura, and this is Lauren.
Yep.
And we're going to start off Shag today, our Shag party class today, with a little footwork warm-up, and then we're going to play with some Savoy kicks. If you've ever done those in, if you've done Dean Collins Shim Sham, or if you've done, maybe done them in Lindy Hop, we're going to stick them in our Shag. So I'll start with the song, and you can just watch Lauren and I, and we'll just do, starting with some six count Shag basics. And then at the end of the phrase, we'll probably just like that last eight count, we'll probably just kind of rock out and twist. And that way we're just kind of following the phrasing. And yeah, or if you want, you can just warm up and do your own warm up. So do what feels good to you. But we'll start with a nice mid-tempo song to get our bodies warmed up and moving. This is Big John Special.
Awesome. Yeah, hopefully that got the blood flowing. Looks like we got a couple more people jumping in for us. I know you're looking at Laura's face, but that's better, probably a better face to look at than mine. Hello, yes, we're back. Awesome. Like Laura had mentioned earlier, we're doing Savoy kicks, which originated, I believe, from the Savoy Ballroom. Savoy Ballroom, of course, is in Harlem. And there's definitely a lot of history and contribution to the Shag dance, definitely to the African-American community. So know that that has its, the Shag has its roots there. Yeah. So anyways, they did Shag at the Voice of Ballroom, by the way. Yeah. So, but with the Savoy kicks, you wanted to see if we can do Savoy kicks in general, just to know them as a jazz step.
Yeah. Why don't we start? Let's just start with them from in Charleston side by side. That way we have time to go through everything, but yeah, let's start with side by side. That way everyone's doing the correct side and getting that from their body.
All right. So what we're going to do, folks, is so normally in Savoy kicks, they were a jazz step. Later on, I guess in the 90s, we started to adapt them and say, hey, I wonder if I can do a lead version and the follower can do a follower version of this step. And that made it really accessible and doable in side-by-side Charleston. So what we'll do is we'll break that down for you. Or Cammie and I will do that. Cool.
Yeah. What does it look like? Will you show us what it looks like?
Yeah, we will.
That's right. In case it's new to some of us.
I need to adjust this camera for a second, so help me out. I'm not... Okay, is this good? Okay, so...
Yeah, good.
If I were just doing regular Charleston, it would look something like this. Bum, dun, dun. If I wanted to do a Savoy kick in Charleston, I could do something like this. Boop, shoot, hop, and then we can go back to maybe Charleston,
Do it again. Show us from the back.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 3. Shoot, boop, boop, boop. Oh, do, da,
yeah.
Da. Yeah, it was cool, right? Shoot, boop, boop,
wah, wah. Yeah, and that is almost 100% leadable. The part that's not leadable is you can't lead your follow to tap their toe, but it doesn't even matter because you're leading kind of a break there. So
what? Lead the tap of the toe? No way.
I'm not a puppet. We're not puppets. Also, Cammie is an incredible follow. I always love watching her dance. So
she was able to do it, but I might have given her a verbal cue. Say, tap your toe while they do this.
Additionally, Mark, do you want to say hi really quick? We have Cammie's partner, Mark, here today. So Mark might jump in.
My partner right here.
This is my partner.
Yeah. Mark might jump in and dance a little bit too, because, I mean, why not? We should all dance. Fine. Sorry, go ahead.
No. Do you mind teaching it real quick?
Perfect, yes. All right, so what I was going to say is, let's do it together if that's okay. Yeah, we're going to give you our backs. So typically, let's do a Charleston basic together. Everybody, if you're a follow, you can watch me. I'm going to move us that way, just inch and forward. If you're a follow, you can watch me. If you're a lead, you can watch Lauren. And let's do a Charleston basic. We're going to rock step first to get started. 5, 6, 7. Rock step, kick, forward, and back. We're assuming y'all have done some Charleston before. If not, this might get a little tricky for you, so you can always go back and watch the recording. Typically, rock step or Charleston, we would count it 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, kick 3, 4, kick 5, kick 7. Rock 1, kick 3, kick 5. So we're kicking on the odds. In Shag, as you know, we tend to kick on evens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're gonna have to switch the timing to do the Savoy kick, which is, we're not gonna think of it as like a Shag move as much as like a shine step or a break. So you'll hit something in the music with this. So we'll have to lead into that. But for now, let's just go from a Charleston timing. And what I'm gonna have you do is, again, we'll go rock step. We're just gonna count this kick forward as count 1 for now. So we go rock step 1, 5, 6, suddenly rock step 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. And you'll see why I'm counting it this way in a little bit. But for now, just go with it. Now what I want y'all to do, everybody stand on their outside foot. So if you had a partner, follows would be your right foot, leads left foot. And I want you to kick forward, kick back. And notice Lauren and I will face each other. When we kick forward, we're upright. And then when we kick back, we lean forward. So forward, kick back. keep your balance. Kick and reach, kick and reach, kick and reach, replace is what we're gonna do next. So my left foot, my right foot, we reach behind and then we replace so that we're upright again. So there's a big reach behind, replace. So we're gonna kick forward, kick back, replace. One, two, here we go. Kick forward, kick back, replace. Sorry, one, two, inside foot. Kick forward, back, replace. One, two, here we go. Kick forward, kick back, replace. So that's the feeling we really wanna memorize today. Is this kick forward, kick back, replace. That's what's really gonna be coming in handy. Let's go ahead and continue from there. We kick forward, kick back, replace. And then this front foot, I want y'all to bend it. And then we're gonna bend down and tap. So after we place forward, my right foot's forward, Lauren's left foot is forward. There's gonna be a bending and I want you, you're gonna end up hopping here. But for now, I can't levitate slow motion. So just bend the knee. And then as we tap the toe, I'm gonna twist to face my partner and bend down and tap. And this is where I said you can't lead your follow to tap, but even you can lead this bend down and it'll look like your follow tapped even if it didn't. So therefore, it's done, it's perfect. So the rhythm is kick forward, kick back to place, and tap. Let's just try that. I'll help you with the rhythm a little bit more. Kick forward, kick back to place, and tap. One, two, here we go. Kick forward, kick back to place, and tap. And on that and, I'm actually hopping on my heel a little. And tap. Try that. Stand on follows left foot, leaves right foot. And I want you to go one, two, three, and tap. One, two, three, and tap. There's a little hop tap, right? So we can kind of feel that. One, two, three, and tap. Yeah, we're doing Savoy kicks. All right, so let's try that. Forward, back, replace, and tap. And this and is a little slower here. One, two, inside foot. Keep forward, kick back, replace, and tap. So remember I said you kick forward, kick back, there's this replace, and the feeling is gonna be replace, hop, tap. Yeah, so after we reach back, I want you to replace. As you bend the knee, think of it as a hop, up, hop, tap. Bend, hop, tap. So we're actually gonna make it a tap, a hop, and then a tap. Let's try that. One, two, inside foot, kick forward, kick back, replace, and tap. Again, one, two, here we go. Kick forward, kick back, replace, and tap. After the tap, for now, let's go ahead and take this one and start a basic. Slow, slow, quick, quick. Yeah? Okay, so let's try that. Let's go forward, back, replace, and tap. And one basic, just so you have that in your body. And you'll notice when Lauren and I do this together, we have this kick forward. He leans me so I feel that reach. I feel the place, hop. And then notice we face each other for the tap. Lauren is turning me in for that. So if you have a partner, try that motion. If you don't have a partner, do a solo. The inside foot kicks forward. When the inside foot kicks back, we both lean forward. Lauren's leading me. We replace. And then there's a hop, face each other, bend down and tap. The hop is hard to do slow.
Nice.
You're already facing each other, so you can start your shag basic. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to jump to this real quick.
Spotlight. Go for it.
Yeah. Out of spotlight. I just wanted to share that when Laura was doing that, as you're doing the kick with the inside foot, that takes three counts. So there's three pulses on that outside foot. So if we were just doing it without sort of the kicky part, I'm going to turn this around. Just so you can see this, I'm not going to swing my Charleston foot just for a moment, but if we were here, we basically go one, two, three. So that's three beats. One, two, three, and then we can replace that full hop, step, tap. Just so you can see, that's the rhythm or the general rhythm. I have one, two, three, replace, hop, tap. And so all the other stuff is applicable. I just wanted to show you that as you do that, you're hopping three times.
Bounces going. Keep those bounces going, I think is what Jeremy's saying.
It's not two beats. It's because sometimes it only feels like you're lifting your leg and then kicking back, which is two motions. But there's three beats in those two motions, right? Okay. So I have to kick forward, which is one, two, three, and then you can play four, five, six.
Yeah, I purposely haven't added counts yet. But let's do that.
Okay.
So let's actually start. I'll just kind of like we did with a Charleston. So we're gonna start with a rock step, kick step. Right? That's typical Charleston. And then add this kick forward, back, replace. So normally we go in our Charleston, we go rock, step, kick, kick forward, bend, kick back, step. Now we're going rock, step, kick, kick forward, reach, replace. And that's what Jeremy's saying. This is happening faster. It's three beats and then go. So it's a little faster than we're used to. So let's try just, before I even give you counts, let's try just adding rock, step, kick, and then just doing that same rhythm, freeze on the tap. 5, 6, here we go. Rock, step, kick, forward, reach, replace, hop, freeze. And then move Shag basic. Again, 5, 6, 7. Rock, step, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're doing an 8 count here, tapping on the 8. Again, rock, step, 5, 6, sorry. Rock, step, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think I counted it wrong. 9, 10. One more time, 5, 6, here we go. Rock, step, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're doing an 8 count Savoy kick basic here. So let's have a Shag basic.
No, I said just make sure that when we say 8 count, we're starting after the rock step. So the rock step is not included in the 8 count.
Let's just make sure we all know the counts. Now that you have the rhythm, sometimes I think if we do counts first, people get weird. So, but let's do them now so you know them. So we have this rock step, which will be our 5, 6 or our 7, 8, whatever the count is of our last basic. So just and ignore it. We have rock step. We kick forward 1, step 2. So we're still on Charleston timing, or we've transitioned Charleston timing. We kick forward 3, 4 is our bend. We're gonna reach back on 5, replace on 6, hop up on 7, tap 8. Now those numbers suck because this is more swung than that, but that those are the basic points to count. So again, rock step is 0, ground 0, 5, 6, here we go, rock step. 1, 2, 3, reach, 5, 6, hop, 8. One more time, 5, 6, 7. Rock step, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, freeze. Or start your basic. So let's add a Shag basic on top now.
Yeah.
What I want you to do a Shag basic with me. Follows right foot starts, least left foot, and let's just do a tap, or let's do step, kick, yeah. 5, 6, Shag basic, slow, kick, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, step, kick, quick, step, kick, quick, quick. Yes, now we're gonna do one normal basic. The second one, instead of a quick, we're gonna make that quick our rock step. So we have basic, quick. Second basic looks like this, slow, kick, rock step, kick. And we're gonna use that rock step to tell our partner, leads are gonna use that, to tell your partner, we're gonna slow down and kick before the next step to change our timing to Charleston timing. So we have this rock step, swing step. Yeah? So one normal Shag basic, slow, quick. Second Shag basic, instead of a quick, that's our rock step. Good luck, here we go. 5, 6, 7, and slow, get ready. Slow, rock step. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, basic, slow, quick. If you have a partner, try this side by side. Slow kick. 5, 6, 7, slow, quick, get ready. Get set, rock step, kick, forward and back, and hop, tap, slow, quick, tap. Again, 5, 6, basic, step, kick, quick, again, with a rock step, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, slow, quick. Yeah.
It's so cool, Laura. You and Lauren look so cool doing that. Nice.
We're just so styling. What can I say?
Are there any, before we play a song, I think we can play a song, right? Let's do that. Before we do though, are there any quick questions that you might have in regards to anything we've explained or tried to explain to y'all?
So I'm going to play a song. And what I'd like you to do is, instead of two basics, let's do four Shag basics. And that will give you time when you're dancing the music to go from closed position potentially to side by side. So we're going to do four Shag basics, but remember that fourth one is our transition. So that fourth basic is where you do the rock step. And that way we can use the Savoy kick to kind of accent the end of the phrase for a little musicality. So I will play a song, follow with me once, and then I'll let you all play just social dancer, practice whatever you want the rest of the song.
Awesome.
So we'll start together the first time. Lauren and I will be connected so you can kind of see what that would look like with us. But if you're solo, it doesn't matter. If you have a partner, decide for yourself whether you want to be solo or connected.
We're ready to jump. We hold the rhythm is jumping. Jump session. The rhythm is jumping. Jump session. The rhythm is jumping. Jump session.
I simply cannot stop that song before that last little bit.
Oh, man.
Exactly.
The rhythm is... We got the approval of Patricio. Thank you, Patricio. You're awesome, too.
Lauren and I both were dancing, and we're like, wow, that's really fun. And it's fun when you do something. Like, you know it's fun, because we're teaching it. But also when you do it, you're like, that really is fun.
It is?
Yeah. I'll pause the recording. And Jeremy, perhaps you could you just review the things whenever you talk about, like, just review the tips that you use to make this really clear? Because I mentioned some of them, but you say it better than me.
So a couple of things that I like to think about when I'm doing this move or leading this move socially is, again, like Laura mentioned, we're starting with a rock step. I am leading the rock step. So my arm comes with my body. And I could basically repeat the rock step. Excuse me. But if Cammie and I were just dancing here and I were to repeat a rock step in my basic, it would look like this. Turn this around here. So I have my Shag basic, right? I can go slow, slow, and I can go rock step, rock step, rock step, rock step. So you can just see this motion of getting us to go back and forward, back and forward, back and forward, back and forward. And like I mentioned, my arm is coming with my body. If you can see that as it's coming back, I'm not really trying to tug my partner, but as long as I'm not just doing this, that would be me keeping my arm in front, but I am bringing my arm with my body. And then I think, Cammie,
Yeah, your left arm is sort of on my back, so she can feel me regardless because I'm going into that connection. She feels that transition as we go into that.
Yeah. So follow steps, take responsibility too.
Right.
And then, keep going. Sorry.
As I transition, one thing I found here is usually when I, in Shag, we step down on the first slow or on count one of the downbeat of the music. So the change that I'm going to do here to really help Cammy feel the difference is I'm going to rotate us in. So if you've ever done anything like kick-ups in Charleston where you do this rotational motion, or even in Shag, you might have done something like this. If I freeze on the inside, it keeps our axis point over here as opposed to in front. So I'm going to do that on the first kick just to sort of help confirm that I'm breaking my pattern, right? So I have my Shag basic. I have slow, slow, quick, quick, kick. And then I straighten out for the step. And then we have this transition. And then I rotate us in again. And then from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do like a lilt or a sway to the side to get us back into the basic. So if you think about those 3 points, if we think about those 3 points as a leader, I'm bringing my body back on the rock step. That's one. I turn in for the first slow slightly. And then when I do that break, I'm turning in again to face my partner. And then I guess the fourth one would be just back into a basic with a lilt.
Hey, Jared, would you just walk through those slowly with your back to the camera so anyone who wants to can follow you, like just kind of going through each part, but can you step forward just 1 foot? And will you do it with Cammy? Cammy, it's great to see you in there too. Yeah, thank you.
Do it solo or do it? Yeah.
Just will you go through each of the parts so that anybody with a partner can do it with you? Just kind of go through each part in the positions.
All right, so let's go to count four of a Shag basic. So join us. We're going to freeze on the second slow. 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow. Now at this point, our weight should be both on the inside foot. I'm going to go now back for a rock step. So I take my arm with my body, right? One, and then I go forward two. And then you're going to turn toward your partner for count three.
That's count one.
Yep. Or that's count one in the beat music, the downbeat in the music. Yeah. And then we step and travel forward two. And then we're going to kick three, four, five. Is that right? Four.
Yep.
Six, and we're hopping 7, 8. And you notice on 8, I'm turning back in. And then I'm going to start to pick up this hand a little bit and do a lilt as I go back into my basic.
Yeah.
And I think it's actually really helpful is if we are turned in, if you're turned in this way, to jump it right in, to sort of jump right in front of your follow, that will really be a confirmation that we want to make that weight change. Let's do it one more time. So I'm going to freeze. Let's all freeze on the kick. So what I mean is this. So it's going to be count one. It'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7. I guess that would be 1 or 7.
It's right? Going to be count one. Yeah, count that as count one for now.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, rock step. That's sort of count 7 or 1, right?
Yeah.
And now I can straighten out for the step. Then we have the 3 beats. 1, 2, 3. Then we have a hop, replace hop. Hop, turn in again. And now I can step in front for the lilt. Quick, quick.
Yeah. Will you do that one more time? Or maybe 2 times, just without stopping?
5,
just nice and slow?
Without stopping. 6, 7, 8, 6. Slow, slow, here we go. Rock step. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow.
Yeah, let's do that one more time together, all together. So just one basic straight into it with a rock step on the quick, quick.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Rock step. 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow.
Okay, I have a quick tip for the follows to think about. Even if you're solo, you can think about this. Can I be your partner, please? So something I think about in Shag and Lindy and Belle is follows. I don't know if you were like me. From day one, we were told to put pressure in our lead's hand on the back. And what that made a lot of us do is kind of lean back against that. But that means that your balance isn't over your feet. Your balance is in your lead's arms a little bit. So what I do instead is I'm going to turn us a little sideways here and have your arms stay there. Is instead of me leaning back, I'm making a big difference so you can see. Instead of me leaning back into my lead's arm, what I do is I scoop my feet back. So my heels are under Lauren's arm. And that way, Lauren feels a pressure in the arm, but my balance is actually forward and ready to move. Now, the reason I want you fellows to do this is because we have this, can we freeze on count four of our basic? We have one, two, three, four. Now, we're all used to doing a quick under us, but if I'm thinking about keeping my balance under Lauren's arm, when he does a rock step, I'm ready to go back, right? And move back. But if I'm leaning back in his arm, can we show that again? Let's go with the basic without stopping. One, two, three, four. If I'm leaning back, I might not feel that rock step. So I want you fellows to stay forward, but scoot your feet back. And I almost imagine instead of me being side by side with Lauren, I actually want my feet behind Lauren's feet. And that helps me to feel everything. So that should help you to feel this. Let's go ahead and just do it two more times all together. Let's do straight into it. Five, six, seven, and slow. Here we go. Rock, step, kick, forward, reach back, replace, hop, and slow. Slow, quick, quick. Try it on your own. I'm just gonna give you a rhythm. Up, up, whatever you want. Try a few basics. Hop, shoot, up, soup, hop, shoot, soup, soup, hop, shoot, up, soup, hop, hoop, ah, shoot, soup, soup, slash, shoot, hop, hoop, ah, shoot, soup, hoop, boop, shoot, shoot, boop, boop, bop, ka-da. All right.
Let's play a song. Can we play a song and see how we do?
Well, Jeremy, my thought is let's add the styling so that people who are solo have something solo and then play a song for sake of time.
Okay.
And that way we can play a couple songs at the end. What do you think?
Okay, I would just get, either one works.
Okay, let's do that just because I want to make sure we stay on time today.
Okay.
Do you want to
do that? Yes, sure. Okay, so I think this is what Laura was going after. Since we're not in the same spot. Is Cammie's hiding behind me. You like how Cammie, she's like, I'm just going to stand right behind Jeremy so they can't see me. No. So we really like this rhythm in general, but we want to make it more like, I guess, Shag-like in the terms of like the numerically how Shag is traditionally done, as opposed to a Charleston version of it. We want to make it more of a Shag version of it where we're going to kick on the even beats. We're also going to shrink it up into the six count rhythm, which is quite different. But
so
it's
you
easy.
Can do it as a styling.
Yeah. So let's do this. Join us when you're ready. I'm going to do the basic weight changes first. So we're going to hop on 1 foot for 3 beats and then hop on the 2nd foot for 2 beats. So watch me. I'll start from the, watch Cammie or me, right? So I have, we're going to hop 3 times for your first slow, right? 1, 2, 3, and then you have 2 beats on the other foot, step, up. Let's try that again. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2.
Can you scoot just a little bit forward just in case it's hard for people to see you? Thanks.
6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, on the second one, I wanna see if we can do the jump hop. So it looks like this. I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it pushes off that 4, right? Yeah, so 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, jump, land, right? 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, jump, land. Now guess what? All you do is tap at the end to emphasize the even beat on count 6. So let's just try that. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, jump, land, tap. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, spring, step, tap. Awesome. You know the rest. We're going to do this, right? 1, 2, 3. So that, the free foot, as my voice breaks, the free foot is going to kick and swing forward.
But we're going to kick actually on that one. So we're going to go one, two, three. And then we have the replace, four, five, six. Right? So we're going to just put it on repeat. And you can join us when you're ready. I'll do it slowly. Five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, five, six. One, two, three, six. One, two, three, five, six. One, two, three, five, six. One, two, three. One more, one, two, three, four, five, six.
How are we doing? How are they doing? I'm trying to look over my shoulder and do it at the same time.
I think it's looking really good. Okay. Will you do it just maybe two more times with the footwork view? And could the two of you give us back and just do it? Why don't you do a shag basic alternating? Shag basic and then that, shag basic and then that. And if you, yeah, if you two, Cammy, if you'll come over on the side, whichever side. Yeah, and if you'll both just scoot forward a little so we can see your feet. And then, yeah, lovely. So let's do shag basic, six count plane basic, and then Savoy kick, six count basic, then Savoy kick.
So here we go, one basic, and then the move, basic, the move. Five, six, seven, basic, slow, slow. Here we go, one, two, three, four, five, basic, slow, slow, quick, quick. Move, four, five, six, basic, move, one, two, three, 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 four, five, six. Yeah.
Yeah, so that was good. That was helpful. Thanks.
Sometimes, I know you're looking at my feet. Okay, good. Sometimes when we're doing this, I do find it helpful to start to do a replace on one. So I go slow, slow, quick, quick. And on that second quick, my left foot's already prepped almost to get me to shoot my right foot out on one. And that helps make the weight placement, weight change easy. So I'm going to do a basic and then look for that as I step on my first slow. Six, seven, basic, slow. Slow, quick, quick, one, two, three, four, five, six, and then I'm back to my basic. Quick, quick. Right? So that's it.
Lovely.
Yeah.
So now is a perfect time for me to play a song.
Okay.
What I want to encourage you all to do is, if you have a partner, do some basics where you just face each other here and see if you can take turns sticking this in. So we would go slow. So maybe I would go slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. And then Lauren goes slow, slow. And then maybe Lauren would take us into side by side. Or if you're solo, you can just imagine you're there. And then when you want, you can do this leg one. Shoot, shoot, yeah. And then start over and go back to open. So you can mix and match everything we've done today. Woo! Or maybe you want to experiment and see where else you can do a Savoy kick. So have fun. I will spotlight y'all first.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Well, we might be off from the music, or if you want to share the music, I can try to have a song.
Okay, you don't have to be synchronized. Okay. People can get ideas, or hopefully they'll be dancing. Here we go.
Hello. Dolly, this is Louis. Dolly, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, Dolly. I can tell, Dolly. You still blowing, you still growing, you still going strong. I feel the room swaying, but the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas. Find an empty lap, fellas. Dolly, never go away again.
On the video. All right, here's our last song, just a tiny bit faster so you can feel what you might social dance Shag to, and Lauren and I will start together as well. So here we go. This one comes in a little loud.
Okay, cool. Let me got loves, we got thumbs up. You folks feeling good? Yeah, looks like it. Any last questions before we sort of segue out of this? I think maybe we might get one more song in there. We can, but just to practice it.
Yeah. Well, we're technically at the end of class.
Yeah. Everything's perfect. It's easy. You ready to do it? And the next.
I have a tip. I have a thought that we didn't mention, partially because the entrance into the Savoy Kick is new today, new to Jeremy and I. It's something that we do it from Charleston all the time. So switching between Shag and Charleston, often there's different ways that you can do it. I just wanted to suggest when you do the rock step, can I lead you, Lauren, for a second? So if I am leading and Lauren is following, typically our Shag basic, we would do step, kick, quick, quick. So that quick, quick, the follows crossing in front. So I want to suggest leads when you do the rock step, really make sure you lead the follow to open up. Mm. Step, kick, rock step. Mm-hmm. Otherwise your follow might travel back with you, but cross in front. And then it's a little harder to feel.
So yeah, good point.
Only tip I wanted to give just to make sure that your follow feels space to actually rock step.
Yeah. Awesome. All right.
So Jeremy shared this link in the chat if you want. We actually created a bunch of videos that you can go to our website and get. There are short clips. So they're meant for you to like watch, learn some moves. We break them down and then pause the video and practice and watch the video again. And they're super cheap. You can rent a video for like $4 or $5 maybe. I think it's super cheap. It's kind of like Netflix for dance moves. And we have Shag, we have Val, we have Lindy. And so check out our website and those videos if you want to just get some new ideas. We have one, if you search by Savoy Kicks, I believe we have a bunch of Lindy Savoy Kick variations in there, like you could stick in your swing outs. Mm-hmm. So then you have some more options. I forgot we have that on our website. And then also I just put in the chat, if you're here together today and you are in a place where you are able to donate towards classes or send some money our way, we greatly appreciate it. Please PayPal using our email address, which is elevatedrhythmco@gmail.com. And we will have more, thank you, good question. More live classes. Yes, so we're only doing this one in June because next weekend is Father's Day. And also we wanted to kind of honor Juneteenth this entire week. We hope you take some time to celebrate the arts, especially arts that have come from Black cultures and the freedom, the emancipation of slavery. And so we wanted to kind of leave this month to let you have some time taking some other classes in Black art forms. So maybe some Lindy Hop from Black artists or jazz dance from Black artists or hip hop or African dance. But I want to encourage you to spend this month doing some of that. And then next month, we are going to do the second and fourth Sunday in July. So I will, today I'll create an event so you can see that on our website. Yay, thanks Patricio, thanks Larissa. So that will be on our website by tonight, the information for that, and we'll have a Facebook event for that as well. So July 2nd, the second and fourth Sundays in July, we'll do exactly like we did today, except different topics. So yeah, I think now we take a little break, huh, Jeremy and Cammie?
Yeah, we'll take a break and we'll play some background music if you want to just wrap up with some of the stuff we learned. Yeah. Or check out our website or whatever that is.
We have Bell Fundamentals Musicality next with Bell Fundamentals. Yeah, you can totally pay for all at once. Our classes are generally pay what you can. So we suggest $12 per person per class, or if you're doing multiple ones, then just pay for like $10 per class per person or whatever you can afford. We always love more if you're in a good place, or if you're not in a good place, we understand that too. So yeah, feel free to do whatever is best for you. If you can just put in the notes what you're paying for, it helps me to keep track. So that's it.
So the best thing that you folks can do in helping us out, if you're interested in helping us out, is just share the videos or share the website. We have the class recordings. I'm gonna leave them up.
We'll keep them up until July. So feel free to share this class recording with your friends.
Yep. So there's different stuff. Anyway, cool.